Well, folks, we've got a lot of stuff actually happening in D.C., legislative maneuvering. We've got the Congressional Progressive Caucus right now telling the Democrats, we are not going to support your bipartisan infrastructure package unless you bring along the reconciliation bill at the same time. We got to do both at once or else we're not supporting the infrastructure package. They're playing hardball, as they should be. But there's another thing happening behind the scenes outside of D.C., that is affecting a lot of what's taking place in D.C. right now. And as usual, it's dark money. A new report from Mother Jones has basically exposed all of the dark money and the Republican donor money that is funding fake studies showing that the Democratic plan to raise taxes on the wealthy to pay for the reconciliation package, oh, it would just have devastating effects on the U.S. economy as a whole. You can't raise taxes on these individuals, these studies claim, because they're the job creators. If you do this, you're going to kill jobs. You're going to stagnate the economy, which is already stagnating. You're going to just hurt everything. We don't know what else to say because it's hard to make this kind of shit up all the time, which is exactly what they're doing. And most of it is funded by dark money, but we do know some of the individuals. You have the foundation of the late Richard Scaife, billionaire known as the founding father, of the right. Several former Republican lawmakers on the Tax Foundation, along with executives from major U.S. corporations, including Pepsi and Microsoft, have authored a study. It's so stupid, okay? I'm not even going to continue reading that because listen to me. We know how this works. We know how this happens. Rich people don't want to pay more in taxes. Corporations don't want to pay more in taxes. But if anybody sits there and tells you that making these individuals or corporations pay more in taxes, if they tell you that's going to hurt the economy, they're lying through their teeth. The tax rates that are being proposed under this current legislation are actually lower than what the wealthy elite and corporations were paying under the Obama administration. Do you remember reports of struggling corporations, struggling rich people during the Obama administration? Were they getting hammered? Were they getting hurt? No. We saw unprecedented growth at the corporate level. Stocks were going through the roof. Everything was great for the top 1%. And all we're saying is we need to raise taxes, and hey, it's not even going to be as high as what you were paying under Obama. But that's enough to freak rich people out. And of course, the irony here is that they would rather spend millions of dollars funding candidates and fake reports like this BS they've put out. They would rather spend millions on that than spending that money to pay taxes. Like, do you not see the irony in this? Like, instead of paying millions of dollars a year to corporation or to politicians so they don't raise your taxes, you could just use that money and pay your taxes. You don't have to pay off people to not pay your taxes when you could just easily take that money and be like, oh, well, shoot, why am I giving it to the government this way? Why not just give it to the IRS? Oh, on principle? I don't know. These people are tax. You can't call them cheats because it's not technically illegal, but they are tax avoiders. And they want to continue being tax avoiders because at the end of the day, it is cheaper to pay off a politician than it is to pay your taxes. And of course, paying off a politician, you get more than just the tax breaks. You get all kinds of special favors. So that's why they go that route. And Democrats aren't even saying that they can't do that anymore. You're just going to have to pony up a little bit more in taxes so that we can pay for these very popular proposals that are supported by a majority of people in this country. But again, even without these fake studies, even without the billionaire money, things aren't looking too great for either the reconciliation package or the infrastructure package right now. You have certain Democrats taking tons of pharma money that do not want to expand Medicare. They don't want to lower the age of eligibility to 60. And of course, you know, Sinema, Manchin, the gang of three in the House of Representatives all taking big pharma money. And it's paying off dividends for pharma right now. And of course, the Congressional Progressive Caucus withholding their votes from the infrastructure package unless we get the reconciliation bill too, that is needed. Because the infrastructure package alone is not going to make the necessary changes to this country. We have to have the other piece of it, the one that actually has the real things, the good things in it. And if we can't get that, then none of this matters anyway. Democrats still lose, at least in the midterms, probably. So force it. Force them to have to take up that piece of legislation as well. Get everyone to vote on it. Get these pharma-funded politicians in line. And most importantly, shut out the idiotic noise coming from the millionaires and billionaires who are afraid of paying taxes. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our channel for fresh content 7 days a week.